people that on earth do dwell, sing to the Lord with cheerful voice. Him serve with mirth, his praise foretell. Come we before him and rejoice. Know that the Lord is God indeed. Without our aid he did us make. We are his folk, he does us.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Mary, dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the solemnity of the most sacred heart of Jesus. It's very important to center our lives in Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Redeemer. Before celebrating this sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for forgiveness and compassion. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in the heart of your Son, wounded by our sins, bestow on us in mercy the boundless treasures of your love. Grant, we pray, that in praying him the homage of our devotion, we may also offer worthy reparation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "You are a people sacred to the Lord your God. He has chosen you from all the nations on the face of the earth to be a people peculiarly his own. It was not because you are the largest of all nations that the Lord set his heart on you and chose you, for you are really the smallest of all nations. It was because the Lord loved you, and because of his fidelity to the oath he had sworn to your fathers, that he brought you forth out with his strong hand from the place of slavery, and ransomed you from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Understand then that the Lord your God is God indeed, the faithful God who keeps his merciful covenant down to the thousandth generation, toward those who love him and keep his commandments, but who repays with destruction a person who hates him. He does not dally with such a one, but makes them personally pay for it. You shall therefore carefully observe the commandments, the statutes, and the decrees that I enjoin on you today. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting for those who fear him.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. All my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting for those who fear him.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting for those who fear him.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our enemies.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting for those who fear him.
A reading from the letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In his love, not that we have loved God, but for that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. upon you, says the Lord, and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel
according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Very dear brothers and sisters, the lensed heart of Christ reminds us of the depths of God's love for us. Sharing our stories of falling in love with God is an evangelization tool we can use to ignite a spark in the heart of another, and enkindling in them a new relationship with the Lord. Moses tells that the people, the Lord set his heart on you and chose you. And John writes to the Christian community that God is love, and that if we love one another, God remains in us. In today's gospel, Jesus says, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. To celebrate the solemnity of the most sacred heart of Jesus is very important for Christians, because if we need to center our spirituality in Jesus Christ himself, in his heart, we begin to depend on him in everything. The author of this precious call to the heart of Jesus and Mary was St. John Hughes. He celebrated for the first time the Feast of the Most Sacred Heart of Mary in 1648. And after that, a little bit more, he also celebrated for the first time the feast of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. And he centered his spirituality in the heart of Jesus and Mary, and he says that Jesus and Mary are one heart. The Pope Pius X called St. John Hughes Father, Doctor, and Apostle of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus and Mary. Thus, this that the cult of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus was created for the first time for St. Genius. Let us try to center our lives in Jesus Christ. And if we try to form with Jesus and Mary one heart, we are happy because we are learning to discern the will of God in our lives. For Hebrew people, the intentions, the dispositions, and decisions come from heart. The heart is the center of our lives. And this is very nice for us to consider that for Christians, if we are centered in the heart of Jesus and Mary, we belong to this precious group of persons who recognize Jesus Christ as Savior and Redeemer. Finally, in the doctrine of the Church, when the Church read the chapter 19 of John, he said that from the side of Jesus, the pierced side of Jesus, comes the sacraments of the Church, especially baptism and Eucharist. Let us continue our celebration there, brothers and sisters, and let us receive this precious gift of the most sacred heart of Jesus, who is love for each one of us. Please stand. Let us profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, whom the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us present our prayers and of our petitions to our Father in heaven.
For the Catholic Church throughout the world, that God will continue to guide us in bringing his word into life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
For the leaders of nations, may God guide them in upholding human dignity in policy and in practice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are poor, hungry, or thirsty, may God show compassion upon their suffering and enliven the community to meet their needs. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church gathered here today, may God give us courage in leading lives of faithfulness in word and in deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially members of this community, may God grant them mercy and everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of this Mass, for Jeff and Letty Kremolsta. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Receive these our prayers, O Father, that we present in the name of Jesus Christ, who is Lord, forever and ever.
What wondrous love is this, O my soul, O my soul? What wondrous love is this, O my soul? What wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul, to bear the dreadful curse for my soul.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, O Lord, we pray, on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we offer may be a gift acceptable to you and an expiation of our offenses. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, and the wellspring of the church sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and one more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that in the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathering our prayer and praises into one, let us pray in the same word Jesus Christ, our Savior, taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on us, even on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold, Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. In the body and blood of Jesus Christ, keep us safe for eternal life.
Let us pray.
May this sacrament of charity, O Lord, make us fervent with the fire of holy love, so that drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our celebration is ended. Let's go in peace, proclaiming the gospel of the Lord.
O Lord, you are the center of my life. I will always praise you. I will always serve you. I will always keep you in my sight. Keep me safe, O God, I take refuge in you. I say to the Lord, you are my God. My happiness lies in you alone. My happiness lies in you alone. O Lord, you are the center of my life. I will always praise you. I will always serve you. I will always keep you in my sight. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight, since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm. O Lord, you are the center of my life. I will always praise you. I will always serve you. I will always keep you in my sight.